Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about profit and loss. First of all, let's discuss some definitions. First, we have cost price. The cost price or you can say CP of an article is the price at which it is purchased. Next is the selling price, the selling price, or you can say SP of an article is the price at which it is sold. Now, if the article is sold for more than what it costs, that is, if the selling price of the article, that is SP, is more than the cost price of the article, then this means there is profit or gain. And if the article is sold for less than what it cost, that is, if the selling price of the article is less than the cost price of the article, then there is loss. And if the selling price of an article is same as the cost price of the article, then this means there is neither profit nor loss. Now we discuss the definition of overheads. Now overheads are the additional expenses incurred on the transportation repair, etc. of the article purchased and these are included in the cost price of the article. Now let's discuss some formulae. We have profit is equal to the selling price minus the cost price. Since we know that if the selling price is more than the cost price, then there would be profit or gain. So profit is equal to selling price minus the cost price. Then we have loss is equal to the cost price minus the selling price. As when the selling price of an article is less than the cost price of the article, then there is loss. So loss would be equal to the cost price minus the selling price. Also, we find that the cost price is equal to the selling price minus the profit. Or, we can also say that cost price is equal to the selling price plus the loss. Then we have the selling price SP is equal to the cost price CP plus the profit. Also we can say that selling price is equal to cost price minus loss. Then the next formula is profit or loss percent, and this is equal to total profit or loss upon the cost price, this whole multiplied by 100. And we have to remember one point, that the profit or loss percent is never calculated on the number of articles, but it is calculated on the cost price of the article. Now let's consider one example in which we are given the cost price of the refrigerator as $700 and the transportation charges on the purchase of this refrigerator be $10, and we also have the selling price of the refrigerator be given as $900. So as the transportation charges are the overhead expenses, or you can say the overheads, and it would be included in the cost price of the refrigerator. So this means the total CP, that is the cost price of the refrigerator, would be $700 plus $10, that is $710. And we have the selling price of the refrigerator as $900. Now we find that the selling price of the refrigerator is more than the cost price of the refrigerator. This means that there is profit, and we know that profit is equal to the selling price minus the cost price. So let's now find out the profit equal to the selling price minus the cost price. So we get profit is equal to $900 minus $710, and this is equal to $190. So we have profit gained on the refrigerator is $190. Now let's find out the profit percent. Now the profit percent would be equal to total profit upon the cost price of the article, this whole multiplied by 100. So in this case, profit percent would be equal to the total profit upon the cost price of the article, and this whole multiplied by 100. So this is equal to 190 upon the cost price of the article, which is 710, and this whole multiplied by 100. Let us now solve this. And this comes out to be equal to 2654 upon 71%. This is the profit percent. In the same way, we can find out the loss percent by taking total loss upon the cost price and whole multiplied by 100. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of profit and loss.